I'm Izzy, and this is Dizzy Quilts and Sews. Welcome to week two of Me Made May 2022, where I'll share everything me made that I've worn this week. So May 8th, or day 8, was Mother's Day over here, and I had been invited to a lobster dinner at my brother's house along with my sister and my mom. So I wanted to look nice and pretty. I wore my newest Rhapsody blouse by Love Notions, made in a gorgeous, gorgeous rayon challis from Rainbow Fabrics. Now, it was a gorgeous, gorgeous day, but it was a little cool. So I wore it with my ready-to-wear jeans. And yeah, I love it. And I think I talked about it in one of my Friday Sews video. I think the blouse is a little bit long on me. And next time I make it, I will shorten it. But it was super comfortable to wear. It fits me well. I love, love this new blouse. So that was Sunday, May 8th. Monday, May 9th was a work day. So working from home on video calls. The weather was nice. It's starting to get a little bit warm. Well, actually, the later part of this week was extremely hot. So Monday was nice. I wore a Vivace Dolman top by Love Notions that I made, I think, a couple of summers ago now, in this gorgeous white fabric that I'd gotten from Blackbird Fabrics, if I remember correctly. I'm amazed that this top is still white and doesn't have a stain on it. I like the V-neck detail, which is fun. It is current and practical. I mean, it's white. It goes with everything. White is one of my colors. And I really love a V-neck on me. So definitely one of my most worn tops during the warmer months. I wore it with some ready-to-wear joggers that are in a tealy color. They are pretty lightweight, so it was a very, very comfortable outfit to work from home in. May 10th was another work day, so another day spent in video calls and sitting behind my desk, basically. I wore my Cadence top in a tencel twill fabric that I got from Blackbird Fabrics. This used to be the Cadence dress, which I absolutely hated on me. So I basically chopped off the bottom and turned it into a top. The fabric is fun. I like the collar detail, which is also fun. It is current. It's got these nice, big, billowy sleeves. It's practical. It'll go with navy, white, black pants or shorts. Not sure this will stay in my wardrobe, however. The fabric started fraying a little bit at the V. I don't know if I cut into it too much when I was preparing the facing or what, but yeah, it's really annoying me, that little bit of fraying that I can see. Also, the facing on this is a bit of a pain and really needs to be ironed every single time I wash this top. It wants to pop out all the time. So yeah, don't know that this one is going to survive when I switch my wardrobe to summer weather. We shall see. May 11th, and I believe that was the day where the temperatures went crazy high. We had temperatures of plus 30 degrees for a few days, very, very hot. So I wore my new sweater set, if you will, with my Lago tank and Harper cardigan in a very lightweight double brush poly. And the bottoms are some Arden pants by Helen's Closet in a light-ish weight cotton twill. Love those pants. They fit me well. They are super comfortable. I have a few more pairs planned, definitely. I like the little set. I think the fabric is fun. The set is fun. It is current and very, very practical. I'm planning on making some white pants that I can wear the set with. I can wear them as separates. So yeah, both the pants and the set are definitely gonna stay in my wardrobe. And although the pants may get worn a little bit less over the summer months when it gets really, really hot, yeah, they'll definitely come back at August, September. So I love this outfit. Day 12 or May 12th, Thursday. Again, I had a crazy, crazy day. That day, my first meeting was at 6:30 in the morning and my last one ended at 5:30 at night. So basically behind my desk on video calls for 11 hours on Thursday. I wanted to be comfortable, so I wore my a ready-to-wear pair of shorts and a itch-to-stitch Seychelles top in a gorgeous viscose crepe, and I made that last year. Love it. I like the fun sleeves. I like the V-neck. It's comfortable. It fits well. It is current thanks to the nice sleeves and boxy kind of feel, and very, very practical. It's a plain color or solid color. I can wear this with black, with white, with gray, with basically many, many neutrals. So yeah, love, love this top. On Friday, May 13th, I wore another Seychelles top, this time my newest one, in a really fun navy and white polka dot rayon that I got, I can't remember where, but I was searching through my stash for something else and just happened to fall on this fabric, and it was the perfect yardage to make another Seychelles. So I got right on that and finished it last week. So love it. I mean, yes, fun, it's current, it's practical. I can't wait to make my white Arden pants so I can wear them with this top. I think it's going to be really, really fun. And actually, I have a birthday coming up and I've been invited to dinner at my sister's house. The whole family is going to be there. So I'm thinking white Arden pants and my newest polka dot Seychelles top will be a very nice outfit for that family dinner. So yeah, so this top is definitely staying. Again, I'm wearing it here with a ready-to-wear pair of shorts because it was 32 degrees in Montreal that day. Crazy, crazy spring. And on Saturday, May 14th, I did not wear Me Made anything. We opened our summer house this weekend. And when I'm over there, especially the first weekend we go, there's a lot of work to be done, a lot of manual work in dirty places. So, and I don't really have, that's one thing that I've learned over the course of Me Made May this year so far, is that I really don't have any Me Made garments to wear on, like to wear for things like gardening or cleaning the house or, you know, going for a boat ride. And I don't know that I'm a whole lot interested in making that type of garment for myself. I mean, usually I end up wearing really old, like old navy shorts and or really, really old t-shirts and tanks. I would be heartbroken if I would, you know, stain or rip or damage any of my Me Made garments. So I don't know that I'm all that interested in spending time and money on that type of thing. So yeah, so maybe me made garments on weekends this summer is just not going to be a thing. I mean, we'll see. Maybe I'll go crazy and start making a whole bunch of pairs of shorts for myself. Who knows? But so far, I have zero interest in doing that sort of thing. And that is it for me today. So that was week two of Me Made May 2022. I would love to hear your thoughts on the outfits I wore, on the Me Made garments I wore. And would also love to know if you're playing along or participating and what, if anything, you are learning from the whole process. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please leave me a like on your way out if you like the video and consider subscribing. Thanks again for coming by, and I will see you soon.